Hello students, in today's presentation we are going to discuss about the filters circuits from chapter 2 diode and their application subject basic electronics. We have already discussed about the rectifiers in the last video, and now today we'll discuss about the filters. So filters are the circuits which are connected after the rectifier, basically in DC power supply. So the rectified output is basically called as pulsating DC. So that is not a complete DC. So to convert into completely more DC, or to be very close to DC, filter circuits are connected at the output of the rectifiers. So filters are the electronic circuits used along with rectifiers in order to get a pure ripple free DC voltage. So it actually minimizes the AC component from the rectifier output, and the function of the filter to remove the ripples from the rectified output to allow pure DC voltage to reach the load and to improve the ripple factor of the rectifier. Now the types of filters, the filters are basically classified as shunt capacitor filter, series inductor filter, LC filter and pi filter. It is actually called as capacitor filter, inductor filter, inductor capacitor filter, and pi filter is CLC, is also called as CLC filter, capacitor inductor capacitor filter. So this is the general block of your capacitor filter. You can see first the rectifier is connected to the AC mains, and then rectifier you connect the capacitor across the rectifier and a load across, and that becomes your shunt capacitor filter or C filter. And the next figure you can see rectifier filter. So center tap rectifier is used here, full wave diode D1 and D2, and then capacitor is connected and then load resistor is connected. Now this is the waveform across capacitor with load resistor, and you can see the output of the rectifier is basically pulsating DC, which is shown here with the dotted lines. You can see positive half cycle, also you get a half cycle, and in the negative half cycle also you get a positive half cycle at the output. And that DC voltage, when it is connected across capacitor, capacitor starts charging. So when capacitor starts charging, it charges to highest maximum value, that is A 0 to A, you can see that is Vm volts. So it will charge to maximum volts, then capacitor starts discharging, that is shown by the slant line that from A to B, and then capacitor starts discharging. By the time the next positive half cycle comes of the rectifier, and again capacitor starts charging to maximum value, that is from B to C, then again capacitor starts discharging C to D, and it goes on. And this is how this is the voltage which is developed across capacitor. So this is the operation of full wave rectifier with shunt capacitor. So in the interval 0 to A, that is when this capacitor starts charging to maximum value, because D1 is on and supplies the current to the capacitor and the load current, and the capacitor starts charging through D1, and at the end of this interval, that is A, it charges to the peak value or the maximum value of the secondary voltage, that is Vm, and the voltage across capacitor is equal to Vm. Now after point A, the secondary voltage starts reducing, and therefore this will reverse bias the diode D1, and the diode is D1 is turned off. Now during the interval A to B, voltage on capacitor is higher than the rectified output, and hence D1 and D2 both remains off, and the capacitor discharges exponentially through the load resistor RL, and as the value of RL is much higher than RF, the capacitor discharges slowly. Discharging time is RL into C, and this reduces the ripple content in the output voltage. Now, operation in the interval of B to C, the B instantaneous rectified voltage is equal to voltage on capacitor. After B, it is greater than VC. Therefore, diode D2 starts conducting at instant B and the capacitor charges through D2. At the end of this interval, that is point C, the voltage on capacitor is again equal to plus Vm. Due to this, diode D2 is reverse biased and stops conducting at point C. And the operation in interval C to D, the operation in this interval is identical to that in interval A to B. So basically what you have to understand is in the positive half cycle, at the output of the rectifier when it is applied, then when the diode is on, the capacitor is charging. When capacitor charges to maximum value, then when the diode is off, the capacitor starts discharging and the cycle goes on and you get a voltage, a ripples at the output of the load resistor, which is as shown by the dark line, and these are called as ripples. Now that was about the C cap filter. Now we'll understand the L filter. So here you can see the rectifier. At the rectifier output, we have to connect inductor but in series, and then the load resistor we are going to connect, and that is your L filter. So the circuit diagram is shown here. We are using a center tap transformer, and at the output the two diodes are connected together, the cathode. There we connect a load inductor and load resistor, and output voltage is developed across load resistor. Now you should know the fact that the inductor passes DC and blocks AC. So due to the inclusion of the inductor L in series with the load, the ripple current reduces to greater extent and the load current is smooth. Higher the value of the inductor, lower will be the peak to peak ripple in the load current waveform. The load voltage waveform is same as the load current. Here you can see the output waveform across the load resistor, and that is the filtered output. That are the very small ripples at the output you get, and this is how it converts AC into DC, but which is very close to DC, but it is not perfect DC. Now next is LC filter. So as you can understand, it is a combination of inductor and capacitor. So you can see at the rectifier output, you connect inductor in series and capacitor in parallel, or capacitor after the inductor in parallel with the load resistor, and that is inductor capacitor filter. So this is the circuit diagram of inductor capacitor filter with full wave rectifier in details. So you can see, and also you can see the filtered output as the capacitor is connected across the load resistor, and before that one bleeder resistor, one resistor is connected before load resistor, that is called as bleeder resistor. Now next is your pi filter or CLC filter. So here you can see at the rectifier output, capacitor, inductor and capacitor is again connected, and the load resistor is connected. So circuit diagram is also shown here. It consists of two capacitors C1, C2 along with inductor. Generally both the capacitors C1 and C2 are of the same value. Now due to use of three elements, that is capacitor, inductor and capacitor, the ripple factor of the pi filter is very low as compared to the others, and the capacitor C1 and C2 provides a very low reactance path for the ripple, whereas series inductor provides a high reactance to the AC ripple. So the combined effect of this is the reduction in ripples and improvement in the output waveform. So you get more perfect DC output at the CLC filter. So this is the waveform output waveform of CLC filter, and you can see here a straight line, so that is the DC voltage. So this is the comparison of C capacitor filter, L filter, inductor filter, LC filter and pi filter. So the capacitor filters, where are they are used and applications are shown here. So this is all about the different types of filters. Thank you.